see Oliver is an introvert.
Thank you, first rank.
So I will go with Omar in this match. But I think it's going to be a close one.
Yeah, I'm going to give Omar the edge, but I think the start of the match is going to be key for both players. They're going to be feeling the pressure. They're not used to this type of setup. And of course, we've got the crowd back as Oliver gets the first break off. And it's a dry break.
I had a chat with Omar this morning. He's a bit older and more experienced, and he's very happy where his game is. Of course, a great result, but already coming into this tournament, and as of late, he realizes that he's getting paid for the hard work that he has done in the past 4 years. When he realized he needed to become a more complete player, went to the States on many trips, playing bank pool and one pocket, which will help you in learning new shots, getting better speed control. And that miss on the one right there, you know, early nerves, has nothing to do with knowledge. It's just the pressure of this big, big match.
Yeah, that was a little bit worrying. Obviously, he was striking down the cue ball, and they were seeing another one. So this is kind of just how we vision this match going, but not the very first two shots of the match.
I watched the beginning of the match between Szolnoki and Shane Van Boning. Szolnoki, the first 10 minutes was all over the place. It's all about rhythm and getting opportunities. Opportunities that will help you to play good positions, give yourself nice shots, and shot after shot, composing yourself a little bit more. He did that well, young Szolnoki, but what surprised most was the coolness with which he closed out the match against Shane and the match against Ruiz Sanchez.
Yeah, he didn't show any emotions there. Kind of like me. I never show emotions, you know, if I win, big wins, trying to stay cool.
Well, you show him, but You have tells, but you need to pay attention. You move your eyebrow.
Yeah, I definitely play with my eyebrows.
But this is the semi-final, and the crowd are back. It's got a different feel today than the previous days. We started with 128 players playing double elimination till the final 64. Then the final 64 was whittled down to the last four, and now the crowd are back.
No, nice recovery shot. Left himself on the wrong side of the five. Omar has really had to dig deep for his wins. Won two matches where he was down 8-2. Three hill-hill wins in a decider. The one yesterday, the last match to get to the semi-final against Kaplan. It was his easiest, so he said. Now he needs to play this with inside, with check side. On the TV table, it pushes the cue ball to the right. Didn't look good, guys.
No, that's two strokes, very quick and very snatchy.
Yeah, he rushed himself on that ball. He didn't take his time.
Extension, please.
I think what you see most experienced, like top dogs, do out there is take time. Could be that Omar has told himself to try and pick up rhythm as quick as he can. But he was misaligned on that shot. Little distance. Ball off of the rail will help Omar because he needs to load up here come with a big stroke. Have you ever?
What an opening wreck we have.
Yeah, and he's getting very fortunate. Oliver looks a little bit shaky himself, but he could be faced with easier shots.
And the last movement on the shot. Well, if this is an omen for the rest of the match, we're in for something. Oh, yoy, that's a good shot. What a beauty.
Very nice touch from Oliver.
Yeah, you need ice water veins to play the shot like that. Very low on the cue, Szolnoki.
Extension, please.
So is he banking this one and going around with the cue ball?
Yeah, he's a great bank pull player. And again, luck on Omar's side. In this situation, what you're trying to do is play the right shot. Play good shots. Try and deliver as good as you can. It's good.
Yeah, Omar's got a small chance here. He's going to try and go one rail and pot the seven in the bottom right pocket.
I would expect, if he misses it, this to hit it thick. Needed to curve, bend the cue ball around the nine. But with that speed, the cue ball didn't have time to open up off of the short rail. What an opening wreck. So many innings back and forth already. Is this going to be the final?
Played that with top spin and on the TV table and brand new cloth and equipment. He just loses the pace. And now he's faced with a little thin one.
Well, this is as thin as they come.
Wow.
What a beauty. First, before, that super thin safety, and now the cut on the eight ball. Nice shot. So he gets the break in rack two.
So rack number one, well, we had a bit of everything there, didn't we? It was all going on.
It's quite nervous, actually. I didn't sleep very well, but I think it's normal. I'm also excited about it. I haven't played on the TV table yet this tournament, so it will be a new experience. I have to be more focused, just focus on the shots, not care about where I am and who I play and how many people are watching. It's easier saying than doing it, but I have to try it. When I started playing at 10, I had the dream to be world champion one day. And actually, at my practice room, I still have like an article about me when I was like 13. The title of it is like, "He's dreaming of being first in the world," or something like that. I have it there as motivation, so it would be great if that dream came true today.
Yeah, great shot on the eight ball. Great to see. Even in the interview, he couldn't get that grin off his face. Imagine if he were to win this match and the final, the grin would be there until September, October. How does that ball not drop? Walk gently, Oliver. So young Szolnoki is taking a risk with that speedy cut break. Applying that so that he can control the one and send it over. Super difficult this. 1-2 combination.
That was a good shot.
He'll take that.
Now he's going to need another one because after potting the one ball, he's going to try and get back down table for the pink four. Can he get into the cue ball enough? Well, he must have played safer. Didn't go for the pot.
Just about got it. He had an alternative, play a very small safety, keep both balls there. Distance is always a good backup.
Showed a little bit of patience, could have risked taking the pot on, but it wasn't for him. Omar, he's off to a very shaky start, guys, must be said. Pedal Ghost, still the world champion.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I'm enjoying this day. Nice.
It's the last.
That's the last one, yeah, unfortunately.
Watch out where the one goes. Good shot. Good shot. Those finesse shots, he plays well. The cut shots before. This one, as tight as possible to that eight ball, leaving Omar a little room to work with.
Where the one ball is, it's acting like a big ball. And that was a good hit.
Good position for Szolnoki to find the safety as various options, but little time, only 30 seconds per shot.
Looks like he's left the potting angle.
Yeah, but I don't see Omar coming back to the pink four. Well, looks like he's enjoying it for sure.
Yeah, you can always see Oliver. He's always smiling.
At the Euro Tour as well?
Yeah, like every shot you can see he's always smiling.
But back home on the European Tour.
Yeah, yeah. What a shot from Omar.
That's going to give him a little bit of confidence the way he hit that ball.
From day two, day three, I've been telling people that I liked Omar's demeanor, that he looked calm, cool around the table. He's playing quite a bit faster than he's done so far in the tournament. And only time will tell if it works for him.
Yeah, he probably doesn't want to hear that beeper too.
So he's trying to get the cue ball up behind the seven to play the brown seven in the bottom right hand pocket. Speed is important. I don't think he played that.
Little rough around the edges, his positional play. But it's not a jury sport. If you make the balls sink to nine, you got the rack and you get the break. And it's nice to watch, I think, if a player loses position occasionally. Don't know if it does his brother Shaheen any good. He's not into nine ball, Shaheen. Sort of a mentor and coach for Omar.
That will settle Omar down. It was a shaky first rack.
It's my dream, you know. It's just exciting to be here competing in the Final Four in the World Championship. I'm feeling great. I was struggling in the beginning. I get lucky, 64 I was 8-2 down, 32 I was 9-6 down, but I keep telling myself just stay calm, just compete, just leave it to pool god, you know. I didn't see Oliver play much, but I do believe that he's a great player, especially making it to the Final Four. Nobody's like, he cannot make it to the Final Four if he's not a great player. I just want to play pool, I just want to be calm, you know. Just thinking about it is just getting me emotional, and I don't want to do that. If I win it, that's a different, totally different story. Like, I don't know what I'm going to do. But right now, I'm just calm, I just want to play the game.
A beautiful setup here in the Marshall Arena. Everyone attending this second semi-final of the World Nine Ball Championship.
Thank you, third rank.
One of the pinnacles of our sport. One of the pinnacles of the Matchroom Tool Series. The break in rack 3 for the Kuwaiti Al Shaheen.
Both players playing the cup break. Often
very tough, very difficult shot on the two. I don't see him attacking this one. I guess again. I think he took into the equation there that the half ball contact with the seven would bring the cue ball down table. Risky shot. He's going all in, it seems, early in this match. Safe behind the three. And an offensive element. This is a sellout. Even if the three ball is between the cue ball and the two, out of 10 times, guys, how much would this ball go down, the two?
Probably 8-9.
Yeah, I would say 7-8. He's the favorite to make this one for sure.
Extension, please.
Omar's not the tallest of fellas.
You want to know, guys, which junkie he's using? Mine.
He's got your junkie, has he, Fedor? Sure you're on a little percent, knowing you.
We'll figure it out.
Part one, the jump shot. Part two, long distance cut and the three ball.
Oliver will have known when he played the safety, it wasn't going to be good enough. He needed the two ball to bounce further up table.
Still not out of the woods here, Omar.
Also, on the bank safe that he played, he could have played it a bit more aggressive and actually gone for the bank, couldn't he?
Nice shot. I think that's the shot clock coming into play, Carl. They feel they don't have time, and only experience will teach you to capitalize on those last 4 or 5 seconds.
Well, he overrun the positional shot. You could see his face. He wasn't happy, and he tried to swerve that in with spin. This is a worrying start. That shot was very similar to Dennis Hatch when he played Darren Appleton in the Moscone.
Yeah, you're right.
In 2010, he did the same on the hill. Similar thing.
Stands very low over the cue. Squats his legs, Szolnoki. It's almost as if he adheres to the stance that he learned when he was 15. Good speed, perfect speed. Bring it over to the right side. Stun run through, that would be. Changes his mind. Gets the cue ball back.
He left himself a little tougher than he wanted.
Extension, please.
Extension called. That's what you have it for. There you go. There you go. Picking up the pieces. Left win by Omar Al Shaheen. And here are some hungry fans. Hungry for a Szolnoki victory. Talk again? Yeah, better.
So, ladies and gentlemen, our first TV break, but now your chance to win some prizes. Yeah, everybody, can I get a, ooh, there we go. We have got some signed pool balls by Jason Shaw himself, the Moscone Cup MVP. And to win them, all you have to do is tweet or Instagram, etc., to @matchroompool a question for Jason Shaw. We're gonna pick three questions. Please make them sensible questions, otherwise they're not going to be read out, yes? Okay, so if you want to win yourself a signed pool ball from Jason Shaw, the MVP of the Moscone Cup, get your questions in now to @matchroompool and there will be three winners.
the Marshall Arena in Milton Keynes, the setting for the second final of the World Pool Championship. Richie Rich and Rico Dix. Rico Dix, a former European champion, in the house to witness it all, the action in this interesting and surprising semi-final.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. The fourth break.
Eldon Oceanoki
is leading by 2 racks to 1 in the break.
First semi-final against David O'Cady. Played a great match. 6 break and runs. A pop percentage success of 99%. It's amazing. Near rack 4, young Szolnoki from Hungary breaking. Oh, that's nice. That's nice. Real good, this. Textbook cut break by Oliver Szolnoki.
Yeah, that was a lot better, wasn't it?
Yeah, he hit this one fuller than the previous one. The wing ball flew in the pocket.
Nice little angle. The sort of stroke and speed that is very comfortable to play. And the sort of stroke and speed that will help you get in sync with the table. In general, you'll see players play most shots at a medium pace. Some harder. Some softer. But around medium speed. Early days, but he definitely looks the calmer of the two and looks like the player who's doing the same thing as he has done in the first 4 days of this tournament.
Yeah, and these balls are sat nice now after potting the red 3 and the pink 4. The 6 is sat nice for guaranteed position on the brown 7. And this, well, it will give Omar just a little bit of thinking time, won't it, in his chair, because he's got a bit of a shaky start.
Can help him. Maybe to remember the pace he played with in all his other matches. We just chatted during the break, Feder, that he's playing too quick.
Well, he's played a bad shot there, hasn't he? He's got it a bit short, Feder.
He's got a wrong angle on the 6 ball. He needs to run into the 9 ball or the 7 ball there, or he needs to punch that ball and bring the cue ball to the same side of the table where he's at right now.
He's running into them.
Incredible, incredible. All he's got to do is land straight and he's won the rack anywhere but where he landed.
He's looking at Don't go there, Oliver. I think he's lucky to be where he is, because he can clip the 7 and bring the cue ball back up table and give Omar a very difficult shot. Wow, that takes a lot of nerve to play that shot. But it was so easy to go long rail, glue the 7 to the short rail and put Omar in a world of hurt.
Alex, you spoke about a percentage of his other jump shot. How do you see this one?
To make it, I think... Well, Omar looked a bit wild before. Fedor is 8 out of 10 still. Omar, 6 out of 10.
Well, it was Fedor, of course, his jump cue that he's got, so must be a lucky jump cue.
Yeah, that's the world champion jump cue that I won with.
But rail first and a lot of backspin on the ball. Straight back. That's how they call this, the long bank. He's very crafty at those.
Well, Oliver Szolnoki's getting gifted rack after rack. complete different contrast of the first semi-final where Albin Ocean put a clinic on his opponent. This has been Edger. So it's 3-1, and in the studio we've got the sister of the man in the final, with Michael Bridge.
Yes, thanks very much, Carl. Yeah, Yasmin Ocean is with me. Yasmin, nerves from you in the commentary box, wasn't there?
Oh, absolutely. It was amazing. And even though, you know, I know the game so well, you sit there and you're just nervous.
With Albin as well, it's hard. He doesn't show emotion, does he?
No, he doesn't. Of course, I know him very well, so I see it in his face. But he was very calm. And the longer the match went, the better he played. So it was a really solid match. And yeah, I'm really, really happy for him.
Yeah, absolutely. This game could be a cracker. Could he even go to Hill-Hill? But Omar, sort of, he let him off the hook there, didn't he, Oliver? He let Oliver off the hook.
Yeah, two great players, had a great tournament so far. But looking at the match right now, everything is possible. I mean, I really cannot tell you who's going to win this one. Everything is still open.
Shows the beauty and strength of this tournament, doesn't it? All the 128 players, fantastic. And you get this unlikely semi-final, but they've shown their class throughout.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, they have proven that they are meant to be in the semi-final. And yeah, from now on, it means taking every chance you get, and we'll see what happens.
Yasmin, thanks very much. We'll speak to you probably a bit later as well.
Yes.
Thank you, Edith.
Yasmin Ocean, she also played in this tournament herself. She got through to the last 64. She beat Jeffrey DeLuna on the TV table. And she also beat Mark Gray. She was 7-1 down in that match and come back and won. So she's had a pretty good tournament herself. This break's working okay, Alex, isn't it?
Well, okay is an understatement. Two textbook cut breaks in a row.
Yeah, that looks similar to the Euro Tour break. Making the long ball and the wing ball, bringing the cue ball to the center of the table. Lots of movement on that break from Oliver.
Yeah, Oliver's, he comes in that bracket without sounding disrespectful. It's not easy to watch, is it? You know, like someone like Fedor or Chris Mellin. They've got very good cue actions and they're easy to watch. Oh. Oliver's a bit like you, Alex. It's not easy to watch. Look, I'm joking. Speechless, Mr. Lely there.
I think, you know, he's a solid ball striker. I like what he's doing. A couple of nice shots, nice finesse shots in his break. And the break working, that's like a catalyst. And also knowing that you have a big chance to have a next successful break.
Yeah, he won a nice shot.
He won a smaller tournament in Romania recently, in Transylvania. Then he heard that Shane Van Boning was in Bucharest, the capital of Romania. And he decided to make the 6-hour drive to go over there, play the champion two sets, and then drove 6 hours back. What a journey.
Well, that was a very shrewd move, because he then went on to knock SVB out in this event. So that 6-hour drive paid off. He's got his fuel money back. He's in the semi-finals.
We'll have an angle on the 8. Won't play this with check side. Just stay above the 9.
Job well done.
He had a break and run position in the previous rec. Went astray on the 6, but not this time. Keeping Omar glued to the chair.
Thank you.
Oliver Szolnoki. He's bringing it to Omar. Omar had a chance a couple of racks ago. There was a big bank on the nine ball. Didn't really threaten the pocket, did it? And he's been sat watching ever since. He's trailing this match. It's 4-1.
First time I played pool, I was 8 years old and I was on holiday with my parents. I really loved the game, so we had to look for a pool hall in my city, and that's when it really started. It was a Kruger cue with a BCA shaft, the one with Oliver Ortmann's name on it. My first hero was Oliver Ortmann, but it was just because his name was on my first cue. When I was 12, I finished third in an amateur championship in Hungary with the men. First success as professional, I think when I was 18, I finished third at a tournament in Ljubljana out of 128 adult players. Yeah, I think that's it.
Oliver Ortmann, his pool hero, former world pool champion. Oji Vaji, Oliver Szolnoki.
Szolnoki is leading for one over.
Really strong. He's settled. We saw him in the chair, no smile. His concentration face. He's very much in it now. Pedro, obviously you're still young, but when you was younger, did you have a player that was like your pool idol?
Yeah, I was always following that selection. I was always following Niels Fayen. That was my idol, and still is probably. I was trying to copy his fundamentals when I was like 14, 15.
That was your big chance to say Alex Layley then, the captain.
Foul shot.
Yeah, you missed the trick there.
Nope, that was my second idol.
Oh, yeah, there you go. Missed the trick there. Saw the scratch on the break. Important time now this for Omar, isn't it? He's got a tricky shot coming up.
Yeah, this is not tricky. Not what he wanted. The four, the pink four, is in a tight spot. Would have wanted to be 3-4 diamonds closer to the three ball.
Gotta watch this. Yeah, he's put a good stroke on that.
So you have cue ball players and you have shot makers. Which category will we place Omar? They're thinking.
I would say shot maker.
Yeah, I'll go with shot making too.
Yeah. But I think he's obviously just a little bit edgier. He's not used to this surrounding. But I feel like if he can just kick on a little bit and put a few of these racks to bed, he'll settle into the match a lot better.
Yeah, time in the chair gives the player the opportunity to settle down. Maybe do some breathing routine.
Oh, I tell you what I've noticed, Alex. To me, his cue action seems too quick coming back and forward.
Well, the thing is, 4 years ago, 5 years ago, or when he came onto the scene, he had this very flamboyant cue action, like a Filipino Chris Melling. And he has worked on it, told me. It's clear to see he tries to be compact, but we can also tell he hasn't exactly worked it out yet. It's still vulnerable. Nice shot.
Yeah, the cue ball was rolling towards the eight and it stopped and it's okay. So this is another free rack for Oliver. Just mopping up the mistakes.
Yeah, it was quite a brutal miss on the seven. It's got to hurt Omar. He doesn't mind. The hungry young Hungarian. One rack at a time. He'll take it.
Yeah.
picking up the pieces. Szolnoki extends his lead. And once again, Omar in his chair thinking about his flaws. The Kuwaiti player Al Shaheen is in trouble. A snatchy miss on the 7 by Omar Al Shaheen. Yeah, and if you put them together in a highlight reel, it spells bad news for Team Kuwait. Let's hope Omar wasn't watching the TV screen, because that would have been showing him his misses. And in the ad break, Jason Shaw was having a chat with Omar, and he was just telling him to slow down a bit and manage his pace a little better.
Thanks, Oliver. Yep. Thank you, his 7th rec. Oliver Szolnoki to break, leading by 5 recs to
him. His last couple of breaks have been very delightful. Let's see how he gets on with this one. He's playing the hard cut break. Pay attention to the cue ball.
Hit this one a little thinner, which caused the wing ball to go lower to the short rail.
Yeah, and I think Omar can pop this one ball, so the big shot is going to be the 2 ball to the 3. The 3 passes the pink 4 in the corner, so that's good news.
Yeah, so the 1 ball, this first shot on, that's actually
the hardest. If he plays it right, if he gets on the right side of the two ball. Nope, don't think he got there. Does he have the angle to go forward past the side pocket for a good side of that red three ball? This is all about what angle he's got. Can he miss this seven ball? No, he's not played it, so that tells us the angle wasn't there. It's a smart shot. Got yeah. the cue ball welded to the round seven. Smart shot with good speed. Perfect speed.
Extension call.
And Szolnoki has to come off the top rail or go behind the seven. Now, as close as the cue ball is to the rail, you can manipulate the deflection off of the long rail a lot by top or draw. I think he can still get there. Lengthen it with high.
So, Alex, in the perfect world, you want to hit that two ball full, right?
I want to hit it. Wow. In the perfect world, this week has been a perfect week for Szolnoki. He's doing so many things right. Just focused on hitting the two ball, and after that, inshallah, as Omar would say.
Yeah, we have a saying on the tour, it pays to hit. That means if you're hooked, well, just make sure you hit the ball. So, Fedor Gorsty's jump cue is serving him well so far in this match. He's made every jump shot.
The magic wand. But now then, snookered on the three.
Knowing you, Fedor, you'll be charging him for every jump shot he makes. So he's made three. So you're probably on about 150 so far.
Yeah, you know me well, Carl.
Good speed. Has left a shot on. But it's tough, it's difficult. And I don't think Szolnoki from here, a favorite to close out the rack. Would be a great shot to jack up, elevate, and get that cue ball back. Two diamonds, diamond and a half.
To try and find the gap in between the nine and the six.
A lot of movement. Can't expect to keep the cue ball online doing that. Now Omar sees the top side of the three. He really should get this. Cut it. Place it below the four and nine. Sticking out. Window. But can he hit that three ball thin enough to avoid the double kiss? And then the three ball should miss the four on the way out.
There you could see the cue ball spinning down the table. He put right hand English on it.
He played a good shot. He played a perfect shot. Now it pays to hit, especially with that 6, 9 and 4 down table. Big chance to resave.
Yeah, like you said, Alex, big chance to resave, and that's what he did.
Now, I've said it before. Only on rare occasions do I see players hit the kick shot with speed. And I really don't see a lot of value in trying to finesse something here.
Wow.
Well, there's good and bad. The bad thing, it's an easy shot. The good thing, it'll be hard for Omar to get back to the pink four. Yeah, it's going to be very difficult, this. That's why he's striking down on the cue ball. Needs it to stop. I think he's okay. He'll be quite happy with that one, I think. If he can cut it, can he get into the ball and come around to 6 and 9? He can. That looked a lot smoother, the stroke. He pulled it back a little slower. The delivery was a lot better. I think that's what he needs to focus on. And I think this will do him good. If he can steal a rack like this, where it's been a bit scrappy. Cue ball's close to the side. This.
Falling.
He's going from bad to worse, guys. What a poor start from Omar in his semi-final campaign. Literally every time Oliver comes to the table, he's having 3 and 4 balls to knock in.
Like it's meant to be.
And he's not even interested in potting the 4 balls. He's going for a quick win. The previous shot, Alex, is a prime example of where he's hitting a shot too hard. He didn't let the cue ball get into
it. I'm sure that Omar is struggling with the length of his backswing. So he was very long before. He's trying to be more compact. But he has lost somewhere between yesterday's win and today his feel for that stroke.
First time I played pool, my big brother take us to a pool hall and he was playing pool, so he get me into it. I was a soccer player in the national team, so once I played pool, I find myself and I just flow into it. The magician, Efren Batares. I was like representing Kuwait for the young like age, and I won the tournaments, like in the final I won 9-1. So that makes me happy and want to be like playing and achieve more. As a professional, like I feel like the first success is 2013 when I make it to the semifinal in China Open.
Snatchy delivery on the cue, also pocketed it clean, could have cheated the pocket. It's easy for us to scrutinize those mistakes. He'll be feeling horrible, and it's a weird sensation for Szolnoki. It must be in semi-final, 6-1 up. It's like a walk in the park thus far.
Well, this is what we're getting paid for, to scrutinize, Alex.
Thank you, the 8th rack.
I think that's one of the key components of if you play Q Sports. I think you've got to have a smooth stroke back and forward. Don't like all this fast.
Well,
not for me.
Omar said he's been working on emulating Josh Filler's stroke and delivery a little bit, which is shorter, more compact, and very with a lot of acceleration. Oh, but it's a toe curling to see. So again, wing ball to the short rail. Nothing down. He can attack this bank off of the rail to the opposite side pocket and hold the cue ball close to the short rail. Not doing that. He's playing defense. And even there, it looked a little bit snatchy. Going out for the jump cue.
Probably be playing the bank shot and trying to make the two as well, maybe.
Yeah, two-way shot. The most important is to get a full hit.
Extension, please.
And keep the cue ball there. Hit it on the left side. Stand still. And follow through.
Thank you.
Yeah, it was a little thin, wasn't it, Alex? You spoke about that. Needed it to be a fuller hit. Now, Omar, can you hold yourself together? Try and claw your way back into this match.
It's all about cue ball control. Yesterday, same thing for Max Lechner from Austria, who succumbed to David O'Cady. Lechner sort of imploded, and him as well. During the match, he started to tweak his technique and trying different things. It's so difficult to stick to your guns when you feel like falling apart. So that's the challenge for Omar Al Shaheen.
Yeah, and this was the bottom half of the draw when the last 64 was made, and Jason Shaw, Joshua Filler, Shane Van Bonin, Darren Appleton, my good self, we was all in the bottom half.
Nice little shot from Omar. Still work to do. Has a slight angle on the four. But he's playing the draw.
Draw shot with right bottom English.
Yeah, he's under hit it.
Needs a smooth stroke here.
Open up the back arm. Well, the result is there, but you can see it's like loading a gun. If you have a small backswing, you need to accelerate more. But he's like bordering on not doing enough on the backswing. Then it becomes impossible to deliver with any smoothness.
Well, he's been fortunate there. Just nudged the eight, so he does have a shot.
Three rails for a longer eight ball. Shot.
This will just install a little bit of confidence back into his game.
Yeah, showing fighting spirit. Don't think about all the misses and mistakes. World title.
Yeah, Oliver beat Francisco Sanchez twice. He played him in the group stage as well. So two good wins there. Now Omar, he needs a good break here, and he needs a nice little split. Is it them wonderful? He really has. The one ball's coming around purposely, trying to get it over that top right corner. Fellas, this is a nice split. This is a good chance.
Two sections, the 1-2-3 up table. So he can prepare nicely the 1-2 for a perfect angle on the 3 to go down table. The purple 5 goes to both sides. I think he'd prefer to be on the right side of the purple 5. on the left, he would need to negate for the 9. Now, always high on the 5. Better high than too low. Too low. Now he has to go around the world, I think.
I think he missed the trick there. I think he should have used the rail above the right centre.
True.
Then he could have come into the line of the shot, and that would have given more margin for error. Now he's going to have to go around the world. 3 to 4 rails. He's going to miss the 8 ball, the 7 ball. The 9 ball doesn't want a full hit. Full hit could be bad news. Trying to use the 9 ball as a blocker. Just a little stop shot, and he's under it this. Has he under it? He's having a look. No, he's alright. He's got there. Oliver's going. Well, he's going to kick this off the side rail first.
Oh, yeah, he's taking his plane cue, sorry.
Yeah, I thought he was getting his jump cue as well. But
well, I like the kick because the 6 is close to the rail, so you can... He could play, like, a half ball hit on the 6 with a bit of right spin and send the 6 to the middle of the short rail, second diamond then, on the left. That's a playable shot.
Well, he's playing the swerve shot.
Oh my.
I think he's jumping with a break, you guys.
Oh, okay. We don't know what's going on at the minute. I think Fedor's right.
Can you jump in a little quicker next time, Fedor? You left us hanging there.
I was just thinking, what are you guys talking about?
Well, I think it's because the break cue usually looks so much different to the playing cue, doesn't it? That just looked like a playing cue. Trying to get the cue ball in behind the 8. Speed looks nice. Good
That's
shot.
Perfect.
It's a big 6 ball, though, this.
So what speed do you guys play it with?
150 mile an hour. No,
yeah?
I'm joking.
No, I mean you
no,
can
I think
double speed or just lag it.
Not lag it. I think he's got to play at a speed where the 7 ball could be his buddy.
I'm playing with a double speed, so if I hit it full like this, the 6 ball should end up on the other side of the table.
Well, you're probably more right than me, Fedor, so I'm going to take your word for it.
I have to test her for Omar. Super difficult if you're under the gun.
This could be a nerve settler. That's better, Omar. That's better. Play your way back into this match.
Okay, momentum has tilted. So much is clear. A good safety by Omar Al Shaheen. And a good pot thereafter on the 6. So the wreck that he broke is his. 3 wrecks down against Szolnoki, and he will be breaking in wreck 10 in this race to 11 semi-final.
Yeah, Jason Shaw is in the studio with Bridgie.
Yeah, cheers, Carl. I'm here with Jason Shaw. Jason, got to reveal, Omar wanted a bit of advice from you. You gave him a bit of tactics just now.
No, he was looking up at me, and he was kind of nodding his head and stuff, and I just said to him, just slow down a little bit, you know, and he was saying the table was a little bit slidier than what he'd previously played on, so I just giving him a little information, just tell him to take a little extra 5 seconds and do what he's been doing on the outside tables.
Was he kind of forgetting? I mean, look, it's the semi-finals of the World Championships. Do you sometimes forget why you're here?
Yeah, I think obviously it's his first time being in that situation, so I just said to him, you know, take a little 5 seconds more and just try and relax a little bit. And I think he slowed down a little bit because of the first few games he was really stabbing at the ball and missed a few ones that he doesn't normally miss.
Yeah, I don't want to boost your ego, but during the ad break, the crowd started singing, Jason, Jason Shaw, Jason Shaw. So you must be glad the crowds are back.
Yeah, it's nice to see the fans back. You know, we've missed them, and I'm sure they've missed watching top-class pool, and it's really nice to have them back.
Yeah, it really is, and they've been top-class themselves. It's back to the game.
Jason Shaw, player to
right
coach.
Omar Al Shaheen is trailing 6-3 in group break.
Where's the cue ball going? Made it nice and square, the one ball, but just a little bit too low on the cue ball. Scary low.
Yeah, he will have been a little bit scared, wouldn't he, watching the cue ball fly back. But he does have a shot at this, down the rail into this bottom right corner. And it's there, that's better.
Very tough shot he's made there.
Good break, good cut on the one. Will he get this one without allowing Szolnoki to get back to the table?
You could tell with the stroke, he seemed to pull the cue back a lot smoother then. It wasn't as fast and then like a sharp stop, so that was a lot better. Same again there. Playing his way back into this semi-final. Couldn't keep gifting Oliver racks.
Still think he looks a little bit rushed. Still chasing proper cue ball position, but it's good enough. So much is clear. Now bounce out to the left side of the nine. Finally, some rhythm. Some dominance, some control over his nerves and over the cue ball. Break and run for Al Shaheen.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to give away some prizes. Give it up, the MVP of the Moscone Cup, Jason Shaw, ladies and gentlemen. Carl got booze, and you've got a big round of applause there, Jason. So we asked some of the fans to send in their questions for their chance to win a signed ball. And so we have three questions here. I will ask if you have been selected, come and meet me in the far corner over on the right-hand side after we've asked our questions. First question from Richard Saunders at Villa Fan Rich. I'm really sorry that you're a Villa fan, Rich. The question is, out of all matches played, what has been the most emotional and why?
In this event?
In all events.
In all events, I don't know.
Put him on the spot there.
Probably,
good question.
Probably Moscone Cup. Yeah, beating Team USA and giving Van Bornen a good hiding.
Cool. The next question's from at Rob Ford 1990. Not including Milton Keynes, what is the best venue you've played at?
The best venue? I think one of the best venues I played was in Omar's hometown, Kuwait. Had the Kuwait Open, that was a nice setup over there. So, yeah, that and London, let's go on a cup.
Yeah, okay. And the last question is from Paulie3012, so Paul Anderson. Anders, what were your thoughts this year on Moscone Cup? Great to have fans back, and what are your European, what are Europe's realistic chances?
Yeah, it's obviously amazing to have the fans back, and obviously it's going to be fun. And
semi-final number two. And it looks like Al Shaheen is in sync. He's mounting a comeback against his opponent, Oliver Szolnoki from Hungary. Still down by two, trailing 6-4, but he'll break in rank 11. Alban Ocean, after a stellar display against Al-Kaidi, 11-4. His victory is waiting in the final. Race to 13 to start tonight at 6.
Thank you, Omar.
Alban Ocean.
Thank you, the 11th rank.
He's in the final. It's his third World Pool Championship final. He's won one, lost one. Can he win two? History in the making. Omar Al Shaheen, well, he's making this a match now. And look at the break, guys. Where's the three? It's okay. It goes past the six. Can he make it two break and runs in a row? And does the seven pass the eight? That's what he's looking at now.
I think it does.
Yep, I think it does, Fedor. Warrior in combox with current defending World Pool champion, Fedor Gorst.
Well, the current, but not anymore defending world champion. He's defenseless. He's in the booth.
That's a very fair point.
That's true.
Sorry,
Fedor. Sorry, Fedor.
It's all right, guys.
I was going to give you a big build-up then, but it's all gone wrong. So Fedor is the world champion for one more day. And you've been a good world champion, Fedor.
Yeah, it's been a good 2 years. Wasn't one.
Yeah, you had the Brucey of 2 years.
Yeah, thanks to COVID.
Thanks to COVID. Omar's going to be playing this into the top right corner, running through with the cue ball. It's very straight, so he's a big favourite to make it.
Checking at seven, so it's close. Still think it goes. But under pressure, like in a high pressure match like this, your perception isn't 100%.
He played it in the right center.
Nice shot, I like it. Yep. Very confident shot selection. So under pressure, you'll see players check again and again if the ball actually does pass the eight ball. It's just difficult to know things for sure.
Would love to land straight on this ball, and he's not, so this is going to make it. Oh, you can see there's quite a big gap. Stretching, needs to just slow down a bit. It's a big shot, it's a big rack. Uh-oh, he rushed it, didn't he, guys? Got down far too quick for my liking. I don't know if he had an extension left. If he did, well, he's shown a lot of inexperience there.
Or take it on the six ball in anticipation instead of using it extension when you've lost position. Because the six, that was the shot to set him up for the problem seven.
Now he has hooked Oliver, so he's got to come with a kick. Can he just swerve it round the eight ball enough to hit where he needs to hit on the rail to pop this? But it's another rack where he's come to the table with three and four balls left. He's going off the short rail. Short rail is what we call the bottom and the top. What a beautiful kick shot, Alex.
Yeah, nice finesse, good control. It's a straightforward shot, easy to see what he had to do there, but not easy to get that exact contact on the seven with the speed.
Well, look at this.
this is a turn up for the books.
Ball shots, illegal contact, ball in hand.
You got to kick at that ball, surely.
And start the clock, please.
I'm not sure. I mean, it's not an easy shot to execute right now, but he was trying to freeze the 8 ball a little closer to the 7 ball.
It's going to be real close to the 8 ball with the cue ball. Tricky little shot this, because Szolnoki, if he doesn't glue the cue ball to the 8, Omar will have a one real route. Or an easy 2.
Omar bought himself a little bit of time. But he's got a kick at this one.
So do you play this containing, just landing on the 7, buying more time? Or do you try and split ways with the 7 and the cue ball?
3 rails could be on.
Well, it's on, but it's super tight.
I'm trying to play 3 rails with the speed here.
So's Omar. You could see where he put his finger. He's trying to hit that point on the long rail. Kick and stick.
Or slide behind the 9.
That's not bad at all, I think.
So what's on offer? A bank on the 7, a carom on the 9. You will definitely attack from here. There doesn't seem to be any good safety. Well, he can play the safe, but any time you leave the initiative to the opponent, you're vulnerable. I say go.
That was the danger.
Well,
he forgot about the 7 ball, didn't he?
Yeah, but
good 7.
It's snookered.
No, he's not, is it?
Is it? Yes, he needs to jump. Not a lot. If the 9 is 1 millimeter in the way, you only need to jump a millimeter. Does it need to elevate this much?
Four out of 4 for the jump cue.
This is a difficult bank, I think, Federer, because of the angle and the position.
Yeah, I'm bringing the 8 ball to the other short rail and going 2 rails behind the 9 ball here. Maybe it wasn't on.
That's okay, though.
Yeah, he played it good.
It's good containing safety.
Keeps control of the table, and he's forcing Oliver Szolnoki to come with a very good shot, be it offensive or defensive.
Yeah, he's trying to get the cue ball in down towards the 9 ball. And he's hit the 8 a little too thick. So this is a chance now for Omar to pull the match to just 1 behind. He was trailing 6-1. He's made error after error.
Let's watch Shaheen's backswing. Is he going to play it compact? Yes.
He's back in this semi-final match. We've got a match on our hands now. He's gone from thinking bad things in his beautiful arena, guys. It really was. This was the safety shot. He did get it safe, but at this level, these jump shots, well, they're always in favour of the player jumping. This was not an easy safety shot attempted. It's a little bit too fat. And Omar finally knocked a ball in. He trails 6-5. We want to see a hill, don't we? Let's be honest, we want to sweat it, we want to see drama, we want to see misses, blood, sweat and tears.
Yeah, it's heating up nicely. Good comeback by Shaheen.
The fans are back. They're enjoying this semi-final matchup. The winner of this will play former World Tour champion Albin Ocean, one of the European
Omar Al Shaheen back in the arena trying to get his name cemented in history. Could he be the next winner? Could he beat Albin in the final? Well, first he's got to deal with his deficit against Szolnoki. Would be the first winner from the UMA, from the Arab world. But that's not his responsibility. He's the player. He's the fighter in the arena. It's just about this match. Better, just about this wreck.
Good break. Breaking head on. Decided to forget about the cut break that he was doing earlier on. And he's got a combination. Two onto the four. Yeah, this is good stuff now. This is a wonderful look at the balls. This is just dot to dot. This is what we call a road map. All the balls are sat perfect. And this is to tie the match up. We've not seen much of Oliver in the last few racks. Nice to see Omar pick his game up and make this a match we want to see. Needs to keep that smooth stroke.
Yeah, he's perfect on the five ball. Needs to draw the cue ball back a little bit. Then two rails on the six ball, and he'll be perfect.
Like you say, using those extra rails to come into the next shot, into the funnel. Play a different positional game compared to snooker. Pool players use extra rails often for speed control. So he had us waiting. He did a good thing to exit the arena, to reassess himself, make Szolnoki think about the tilting of the fortunes in this match. Comes back and breaks and runs for the equalizer. Six apiece. The race to 11 is now a race to 5. Beautiful head-on break by Omar Al Shaheen, and then after an easy 2-4 combination. A roadmap. Especially because now he does control the cue ball opposed to the opening stages in this match. He's looking the better of the two, but it's 9-ball pool, winner breaks, break to 11. Expect the momentum to switch back and forth. If, of course, Szolnoki in the chair keeps his calm.
The fans are back. She's enjoying her drink. She's enjoying the pool. Looks fine, pal. Your hair looks fine. Yep, you've had a mare with yours.
The slicer. Action, fans. Omar Al Shaheen. He's had a mare in the opening 30 minutes of this match, but he's back in it, breaking, making balls and willing that cue ball to halt in front of the side pocket. Was going to be seeing a push out.
Yeah, and the 2-9 combo looks on, but it could be moved at some point, so this is an interesting little rack that's going to unfold. After the break, the player can always play a push out. After he's done that, the incoming player will play the shot or pass it back. So Omar's just going to have a think about where he wants to put the cue ball.
Now, often in a difficult push out position, you can also play for a jump or for a kick shot. I like playing push out for a kick, but the difficulty on a TV table that is just that bit easier to judge kick shots. So, in that regard, you cannot be as aggressive as you would be in other conditions. Do we like this? I play it. I don't give this back.
Yeah, I liked that shot. I'm playing that too. Do you just roll it and lift the cue ball behind the nine ball?
Yeah, play it soft, I think. He was comfortable playing that type of shot early in the match. How has the seat treatment affected him? It has affected him.
That's and the 2-9
painful
combo.
Mistake. Yeah, 2-9, sitting ready. Two shots from now, and he's gonna fall behind by 7-6.
Here she is, the 2-9 combo for a quick rack.
It's not 100% gimme, it's not. A hanger needs to cut that 2 into the 9. A push out by Shaheen. Szolnoki had to go for that safety. But a double kiss, a dreaded double kiss, allows Omar Shaheen to take the lead. Magical switch in momentum in this match. It's amazing, eh? Al Shaheen looked to be in all kinds of problems and a good running, good shots, some mistakes by Szolnoki. And he looks to be the favorite to go through.
Yeah, he's been fortunate. The pool gods have been kind as well, because you know, you can play many pool matches where you make one little mistake or something like that and can cost you a set. So he's been fortunate to still get the chances in this semi-final, because many a pool player have lost big matches making one or two small errors, and he's made some clangers. but he's dug deep and he's in front.
I can't help but think about the Whirlpool Masters, the other event in the Matchroom Pool Series recently played. Alex Kazaki's winning the final 9-0 after a nightmare of a semi against Eklund Kachi. Scraped the W with a 7-6 win, but in the final, he was loose as a goose.
I like this break, the old traditional style pool break, straight down the middle, park the cue ball, and pray it's your day. Is there another combo? Two onto the four.
It's on. If he could play it as a two-way shot attacking the eight ball as well, that's nice.
But it's very tough to manipulate the cue ball there if you play it.
Yeah, it's so thin on the two. The nice thing about it, it's tough, but it is lined up towards the pocket, so you can ignore the four and just pick a spot in the pocket where you're aiming the two ball at. Yeah, sensible shot.
Smart shot. Very smart.
Sensible shot. Executed nicely. Very nice indeed.
Extension, please.
But it's an opportunity for Szolnoki. It's an easy hit. And many trees in that section of the table to hide behind.
So this is the kick where you don't want to play with the double speed. You want to just play it slow.
Foul shot. Illegal contact ball and
it was a big ball. And it was a poor kick shot. It should really be hitting the two ball from there.
Yeah, didn't compensate for the slide on this TV table. It's impossible to simulate the playing conditions on any other table. The playing conditions with the slick cloth. It's a golden opportunity for Al Shaheen. Look at his face. This is a different person from the one who was playing in the opening half hour of the match. Focused, convinced.
Just needs one good shot here to get back down table for the purple five. The eight ball's over the top left corner. Sitting nice for the nine ball. Well, 20 to 30 minutes ago, we couldn't have predicted this scoreline, could we? But he's relaxed into the match.
Yeah. I'm sorry to say this for Oliver Szolnoki, but against Shane, the American didn't get to set his teeth in the match. Ruiz made a comeback, but then an unforced error, you know, gave back the momentum to Szolnoki. Everyone was questioning how he would hold himself in the chair. And he has a hard time, Szolnoki. Shaheen looking confident. Leads by 2, 8-6.
Here you go.
You're up here.
And then I'm going to ask them who they think is going
to
win.
Yeah. Go for it. I'm up.
So, ladies and gentlemen, An absolute incredible comeback so far from Omar Al Shaheen. The Tiger is on form. A Tiger never changes his stripes. But I think it's fair that we finished the question that we had with Jason. Apologies. We came out of the ad break and the sky had to make sure our mics were turned down. So let's finish that question. And it was from Paul Anderson, and that was what you thought of this year's what are your thoughts heading into this year's Moscone Cup? And great to have fans back. And what are Europe's realistic chances?
Yeah, obviously we're going to win again. That's a silly question. Now, obviously, it's going to be tough. You know, they put actually last year they played okay. We won a lot of matches 5-4, so it was a. It seemed a big landslide, but it wasn't really. We won a few critical matches and we got the win. But yeah, we're going to bring it back again.
Of course, some exciting players up for grabs to get involved. And have you got some eyes on players at this moment in time that obviously you're going to put a word in to try and see if they can make the squad?
That's not up to me, obviously. That's up to the captain and the vice captain. I'm sure they're watching. So, you know, there's a lot of players playing good at this time, and there's a couple of big events left. So we'll see what happens.
Ladies and gentlemen, round of applause, Jason Shaw.
Welcome back. It was this missed kick shot from Oliver Szolnoki that gave Omar Al Shaheen ball in hand. And he's opened up a two-rack lead. We've got a match on our hands. That was the simple nine ball. 8-6 to Omar. Playing a lot better now. Matchroom pool series of events. We've had a lot of tournaments in the recent few weeks. The Predator Championship League pool was won by Albin Ocean. He's in the final tonight. Then it was the World Cup of pool. Team Germany won that match. And then last week in Gibraltar, Kaza Boo Boo, World Pool Masters champion. Who is going to lift the biggest title of them all? Could it be this man at the table?
Looking to attack the two ball. It's a thin cut, but he's well able to make sure to overcut it. Just like a two-way shot. Don't miss a tick.
It's a chance. It's a chance, guys, isn't it? This is a genuine chance. Needs one good pot. Cue ball is going to naturally come off the side rail.
Needs to stroke it. He's rolling. Can he stay above the three? Oh, that's a great shot, showing a lot of bottle. Given the circumstances, and Omar Al Shaheen overtaking the initiative, what a shot.
Went in nice and clean as well, didn't it? That's always a nice feeling. Unlike that one, but it's gone. Been sat in his chair a little while. The match has turned on its head. He was leading 6-1. Must have thought this is all going nice. Omar's then fought hard. Come back. But he's still in this semi-final. Can still do it.
This would be super strong running out from here after the three ball. I fancied him to make that three. Taking his time, checking the clock. Doesn't necessarily need to get close to the seven, make sure of the angle. Pointed it out center table with a low right hit on the cue ball. Medium speed. Now, most players would swing it round. I expect him to. Use the rails, short, long, long. Get to the right side of the nine ball. Appreciating his positional shot, this last one, to stop the rot. Oh. That one wipes its feet, but he has done well, losing seven games on the spin, then pocketing that long shot on the three. He did it. He has regained control, still trailing by one, but his break in break 16. Convinced, they're not thinking about the money, they just want this campaign to continue. How can you be cold in this arena? Cheer on your man, your Hungarian Szolnoki, who will break in the 16th. Seems so long ago he had that good cut break.
Thank you, Rec 16.
Do you still have the timing, Oliver?
Trailing 8-7.
Three-quarter ball hit, medium hard, a lot of follow-through. No luck. Well, at least he sees the one, but there's no pot on. Now, if he would see... If you could hit it a little to the left, the one, he can stun his cue ball behind the 7 and 9 and play a lock-up safety. Oh, this is difficult. He can cross the 1 and withdraw and left to get the cue ball out to the long rail and then go to the 7 and 9, but that's super tough.
Push out called.
He can also jump that ball if he feels good.
Yeah, but it's a tricky jump. And you have to be... I mean, you are a specialist and you played that jump and the cue ball went off the table. You pocketed the ball. I mean, you needed a lot of nerve. But more than anything, hit it perfect. I like the patience that Szolnoki shows here. Window of opportunity.
Both players
having a good look there. You could see Omar. He was wondering if he'd left him a sight at the one ball.
You can't pot it. Pointed out that he is looking to overcut the one. Tried to swerve it and has not left an open shot.
Wasn't far away.
No, nice try.
Omar's got a wonderful chance of a good safety now, though. Yeah, look at this.
The escape is very playable. I don't know if I would be happy having played this safety. Could have played it tighter.
Cue ball is close to the corner, and it's gone.
That's very unfortunate.
Now, the one in the open, a ball in hand, but does that two ball pass the purple five? It does not.
Speed is going to be key here, because he's got to try and find that gap in between the eight ball and the purple five. If you hit it too hard, it could slide in behind the five. That's nice.
Okay, good shot. Perfect speed, right about where he indicated. To the rail and out. He's done this before in this match where I thought he would pound it to the rail and come out to the ball and then played it with draw. It's harder to control like that.
Very nice shot on the five ball. Controlled the cue ball perfectly there.
Feder, you've been in this situation in the previous edition. How hard is the player working to keep that focus on every shot? Is it? Do you feel any rhythm, or is it just one ball at a time?
Well, in my case, it's one ball at a time, but of course it's very tough to stay concentrated, you know. It's a semi-final. He played so many matches before already, and he feels that he's exhausted because of that, I think. So it's very tough to be focused now.
With the momentum change in this match where he was trailing.
excited about the news about the Moscone Cup and the US Open.
Yeah,
it's
definitely.
Really growing though, isn't it?
Yes, it's amazing.
Brilliant. Yep, so much to look forward to over the next few months.
Christina to catch there with Michael Bridge. She was one of the 8 lady players who entered this tournament. She's also the girlfriend of our co-commentator, Alex.
Break.
No, Fedor Ghost.
Nice one, Carl.
Thoughtful expression on Szolnoki's face. But this is good news for the Hungarian. He is going to be getting back to the table.
The crowd was getting a little bit excited there because the 9 was tracking towards the left centre. Not seeing many golden breaks.
Nice timing. It's not brute force. He sees a minor part of the 2 ball. It's a difficult shot this. Must have recognized the danger of a doubled kiss, especially with his one pocket experience.
Chance for Oliver now. Trails 9-7. The poor safety shot from Omar. Needs a good shot here though. Got to control the cue ball. Drawing it in between. This looks good.
Good speed.
Oh, this is real nice. Be
good
happy
speed.
With that one.
That is golden. First opportunity at the table. Landed on a dime. Almost dead weight, as soft as he could. Nice, like it. That was a good shot, straightforward, but he keeps on controlling the cue ball. On the brown 7, he just needs to be straight in on that ball. Straightforward. But in this high pressure situation, doing the simple things right or perfect is easier said than done. Loaded in. A little angle on the 8.
Took advantage here was Oliver. It was a job well done. He got to the table because it was a poor safety attempt from Omar. This match, he's getting ever closer. He just trailed by 1 now. Omar 9, Oliver 8. US Open Pool Championships, Atlantic City. Here we go.
13th till the 18th of September. Fedor Gorst, you will be there trying to snap that tournament off.
Absolutely, Carl.
256 players. Probably about 30 pool tables. 33 pool tables to be exact. That is going to be special. It's at the Harrah's Resort in Atlantic City.
Yeah, Joshua Filler, holder of the title, already won a previous event in the Matchroom Pool Series. Recently, the World Cup of Pool, a doubles event, joined forces with the German Christoph Reintjes, who unfortunately had to withdraw from the event due to COVID measures. There was a person on his flight over to the UK that was tested positive, so he got the call and was told to self-quarantine. A shocker.
Thank you, the 18th break. Oliver Szolnoki to break.
The fans are back for finals day. That's where the other 15 tables was placed for this event. 16 tables was in the venue. There's just one table remaining. Oliver to break. Trails 9-8.
Beauty.
Needs a three ball to keep rolling. It's a thin one, but it is a shot.
Yeah, and the good thing for Szolnoki is the distance off of the rail of the three ball, like a ball's width. Plus, that it stopped just high enough so that he can play the shot not having to spin the cue ball. Just go back and forth. His next shot will be on the pink four. Maybe he's considering a safety. What do you think, Feder? You pointed out a spot on the table.
Well, looks like he's playing safety, but
he's good at those cut shots. Wow.
Yeah, I'm surprised he didn't go for it, but played good safety there.
Yeah, very good. Mixes it up nicely. Offense, defense. But most important in this match, guys, is the fighting spirit of both. When Al Shaheen overtook the match, made that comeback, was up 8-6. I was fearing of a Szolnoki implosion, but none of that.
No, he's held himself together. It's the biggest match of both of these players' lives. The patience has paid off for Oliver. Decided the thin cut wasn't for him and played safe. Omar scratches. Can Oliver tie this match up to 9-9? Ball in hand.
Really, table here is wide open. Come across for the four to the same pocket. That's where he's spotted in the three ball. Don't see anything going wrong from here, but it's 9-8, it's the semi-final. We've seen funnier things happen this week, or funnier, worse. I like how he's playing his position, he's very positive. Where does he go with this angle?
I think he's staying on the same side where the six ball is. Nope.
playing a good cue ball, really. So much heat out there. Very impressed by his mental game.
Yeah, and they've played their matches on the outer circle of the arena, so the winner of this match obviously comes back to play Albin on the same table, so they've had a bit of a practice. They're used to the table for the final.
Two rotations further and he would have been in a tight spot. This is okay.
Needs the cue ball to roll. Oh, that's a bit of an edgy one. It's a thin one, but he could have done with a cue ball even on the opposite rail, would have been a lot better. Still fancy him for this one. Sure. Pockets play pretty generous here. Sliding in. We've seen it a few times. But it's still a big shot. This to tie the match up.
Oh, nice. Holds himself together. So strong, Szolnoki. A good break. He had a makeable three. Played safety and got paid. Ball in hand. A run out. And then the equalizer. 9-9 in a race to 11. After Szolnoki's safety, Omar Al Shaheen missed contacting the three. And with ball in hand and solid cue ball control, 20-year-old, equalizes this match 9-9 in a race to 11. This is what it all boils down to. A race to 2 for a place in the final. How big is that break? How big is that break in the best of 3? Two contrasting matches. Albin Ocean running away with the match after David O'Kady missed an open shot in the 4th.
We all tied at 9 racks each.
9 racks each. Great fight back by Al Shaheen, being down 6-1. But he has left the door open. An opportunity taken two-handedly by Szolnoki. Shaheen will get back to the table. No way that Szolnoki will attack this 2-6 combination. Played a smart, patient safety in the rack before. A little bit unlucky not to have an open shot. He's really breaking well. This is probably his best asset in his match.
Yeah, he wasn't breaking that well in the beginning of the match, but he found that break now. He's making both balls all the time. So what is the shot now? Is he rolling the 2 ball to the long rail and trying to be
He's
behind the 6 ball?
At hitting the 2 ball straight, following with the cue ball. I'd like to cross it, put the 2 mid-table. Okay, I'll take that back. I like this. Simple. He's done that a couple of times in this match, played a real simple shot, which is not as simple as it looked. Many pool players have difficulty rolling the ball with good speed control. The elevation wants to get back towards the 6 perhaps.
A little bit harder would have been lovely. Both players looking down the line of the shot. Can he see the potting angle? And how much of the pocket does he have?
Yeah. Positive on both questions. He can make it and he has a full pocket. Doesn't necessarily need to try and avoid contacting the 7 with topspin and a little bit of speed. He'll go through that 7. He's not going to fall behind the 3 ball off of the 7. Bear down, make the ball.
It's understandable. It's very tense out there now. You just feel the first player to get on the hill. It's going to be crucial for that man. 9-9, race to 11. That was a chance though. Needs the cue ball to slow down. It's okay, it's probably a little straighter than he would have liked. He's down quick though. Oh, that was a good stroke.
Very good shot, perfect speed.
Really likes drawing his rock. It's almost dead straight on the 5, so he checked if he likes stopping his cue ball there. Maybe a tad of right spin to make sure he gets to the left side. Had enough angle to punch it round.
Doesn't want to be straight. Doesn't want to be on the rail.
Tester needs to jack up.
Doesn't need to get too adventurous with the cue ball though. That's fine. That's perfect.
Yeah, good shot. hill. One more nine. Look, very distant when he was down 6-1. But he has done it. He's going to be breaking for the match. In rec 20, one more rec, and Omar Al Shaheen from Kuwait will be in the final up against Alvin Ocean. Here are the stats. Al Shaheen's long game is good, 88%. Pot success a little bit better for young Szolnoki. But safety errors, look at that. That might be the decisive factor. 7 safety errors by Szolnoki versus 3 from Omar Al Shaheen.
Yeah, and the missed pots, Al Shaheen has missed 7. They was all in the first part of this match, and Oliver's missed 3. And that 2 ball could be the biggest ball he's missed of his career, because it was a chance. At this level, they simply have to go. He's going to need the remaining 2 racks of this match to book his place in the final. But first of all, he's going to have to sweat the break of Omar Al Shaheen. 10-9. We anticipated this match was going to be close, and it was.
One. 0.6 is the average ball that Al Shaheen makes on the break.
Thank you, it's rec 20.
It's being more productive.
Omar Al Shaheen breaking on the hill, leading by 10 recs to him.
Will Szolnoki get back to the table with a chance to avenge, to set that missed 2 ball right?
Oh, look at the cue ball control. The 2 ball's going over towards the top left. This is his chance. This is all you can ask for. In any match, when you're on the hill, do you get a chance to win? And this is definitely a good chance. Just got to hold himself together. Seems a lot more relaxed now, doesn't he? He doesn't look as scared walking around the table.
Looks 4 years older, though. It's been a rough ride. That's good. Far enough off of the rail.
Oliver Szolnoki. He's had a wonderful tournament. He beat Player of the Decade, 5-time US Open pool champion Shane Van Bonin, and now he's ball watching. There's 4 balls left. Can something happen for him to stay in this semi-final match? This is going to be the key shot. What type of angle is he going to have on the 7 ball to get down for that 8? Oh, this looks good.
Yeah, that was a nice shot.
Maybe just run on a little further than he would have liked. He's down pretty quick. He's going to play a delayed draw shot to cheat the angle. You've said a few times, Alex, he seems to like drawing the ball, so this is something he's going to be more than comfortable with.
Yeah, but he would like to not play a full draw, but just a little bit of stun draw. If he could help that cue ball just a bit to the right, yeah, the perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect.
Yeah, hit that as good as you can hit it. He's done well. It was a shaky start. The pool gods, they've looked after him, and he's played a great second half. Ooh, that's okay. It's okay. This 9 ball to be in the world pool final.
Omar Al Shaheen, he does it. A lot of heart, a lot of character to fight himself back in this semi-final. It looked like Szolnoki was running away with it. 6-1 down, got the lead, and then the Hungarian who fought back to get a grip on things. And on 9-9, Szolnoki missed a 2, and that was his last act.